live wire. I'm with obviously Mr. Moo Moo. And before we have our very special guest Taboo from the Black Eyed Peas, we're going to be talking to him about a lot of things.
Very excited.
You wanted to hold over because
Everybody's on Twitter and they want to know about this announcement on the 28th. I'm getting, is it a big live stunt? Are you moving hotels? There's a new show. Are you coming back to A&E? There's just all this speculation. Are someone pregnant? I mean, it's just everything on the 28th. What are we gonna find out? I mean, these are your fans. This is the inner circle. I say you just tell. I know legally you can't, but I say just tell them right now.
I can't do it. I've given the hint that you can that. About what it could be, and then
how excited are you about the 28th?
I am insanely excited about the 28th. I've been waiting for this for some time, and I'm being very careful how I choose my words here.
Will this affect every loyal? Like they'll be able to whatever this is experience it?
Yes. Loyals will be able to experience.
So we can rule out you're not moving theaters, right?
No, I'm not moving.
You're not moving. You're definitely.
We could never move that show.
So you're okay. So it's not that. So it's something to do.
But we are talking about maybe doing some dates. We are talking about doing some dates.
But this is not personal. It's a.
It's a career. Yeah.
It's a career changing.
Yeah. It's a career changing thing. So we'll leave it as that. But the 28th, you will know more about it. And more importantly, right now.
We have, I mean, this
Hold on, I know, I'm sorry to interrupt. How should the loyals see?
Is my mic all right, guys? Okay, good.
Where will the loyals see it for? On
I
your
feel
Twitter?
Like we're doing a Stu Stone.
I know, we're live.
The thing right now, the microphone goes off.
So, should your loyals watch your Twitter? Where will be the first place they'll be able to see
honestly,
it?
It will be,
I would assume it'll explode.
I don't know how big the explosion will be, but the announcement will be, on the internet, you know, you'll be able to get obviously from my Twitter,
they should watch your Twitter.
From my website.
Do you have a time on the 28th?
I'm sure you'll Twitter.
Oh, I'll totally retweet it. Yeah. Do you have a time on the 28th?
I don't have a time. No.
Stay tuned. The 28th.
Yeah. Coming from California. Big news from California.
Big news. Big news.
Big news.
All right. Well.
Yeah.
I was just getting a lot of heat, and they wanted to know.
Yeah, I know. I believe me. I want to tell you, and that's why I think Luke actually posted a tweet with a picture saying to come.
No, because you've been posting photos of your live show. So a lot of the magicians on iTrix were talking that it's a change or something's going to happen with the live show. But you might.
I can assure you one thing. We are not doing less shows. We are not changing hotels. We are not closing. Believe is an
because
enormous
success. I'm going to say if your announcement on the 28th, we're raising our ticket prices by $10. I'm gonna be like, BS. It better be good.
But you at the bargain show though. Then you don't have to.
Then you can come see my show. Well, if you can't afford his show, you come see me.
Yeah. But we're digressing here.
Hold on a second.
We got a guy that's involved in a band that has won Grammy Awards, sold over 55 million records.
Wow.
Has I think the most consecutive number one. Hits back to back on the Billboard charts, and is the very first Mexican
Ricky Martin
Mexican
Ricky Martin?
Viewers
no.
that played the Super Bowl.
No, it's not.
This
Ricky.
Is this
it's
is like it does, I remember sitting back and watching the Super Bowl and watching the Black Eyed Peas, and they did an amazing show. I mean, technologically, I have mad respect for them because they're always pushing the envelope.
We should get them on the show.
We should, and as a matter of fact, let's get them on. Right now.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Taboo!
Yeah!
Yeah.
Yeah!
Welcome.
Nice to see you, man.
Welcome to the show.
What's up, man?
What's up, man? Ricky
Thanks
Martin.
Thanks so much.
Ricky Martin.
Ricky Ricardo.
Ricky Ricardo. Lucy!
Thanks so much for coming out, man. This is awesome. This is really, we've all been buzzing about having you on. You know, we're all big fans, and, you know, we haven't had anybody this big on, probably, right?
No, this is
big. This is probably.
I'm sitting with
a pretty big deal right
here. He doesn't even know my name.
I heard you're like one of the funniest comedian, magician, / heartthrobs in Vegas.
I don't know about that. Look who's looking
at
money.
Look at your shoes.
No, look at your kicks. Look at your kicks.
You got the shoes. Nice.
But look, they got the shoestrings undone.
You like that? Yeah,
a little zipper on the, check out the zipper on the side.
Look at how shiny your shoes are. I love the scuff. Like,
yeah, you like that? It's because I'm going to have to spin. That's why I'm bargain afternoon show right there. He's got the bling watch.
You look great, man. We met recently. Yes, you were working in Vegas. You do a lot of DJing stuff as well. You do a lot of special appearances, which all of your appearances that I've been to are just crazy packed. Great crowds. You have such huge fans that are devoted. They come from everywhere to see you DJ and wherever you're doing an appearance. And the one thing is that you love what you do, man. Yeah. You like always writing music, always doing different things. How did this all start for you, man?
Since I was a kid, I actually owe my career to my grandmother.
Really?
She was the person that inspired me to believe, to dream, to go after whatever I wanted to do. Because my parents were like, "Oh, you need to go to school." I was like, "I don't want to go to school. I want to be an entertainer. Mm-hmm. I want to be a musician. I want to be a dancer." And that was my dream as a kid, and my grandmother was the one that instilled the drive and the passion, and I owe everything to her, you know.
Because I have probably a similar story, same thing, parents had to go to school, right? So I just would imagine that you were in your bedroom probably doing music, mm-hmm. doing break dancing, right? Then getting out in the streets and doing it, performing mm-hmm. wherever you could. But how did you make that huge leap from that to Black Eyed Peas?
Well, thank God I had a strong foundation with the people that I surrounded myself with at school. Actually, my manager, David, we went to high school together, and we had a group together.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we were in high school dreaming to be successful in music industry.
What was the name of the group?
It was called United Soul Children, USC, because we're from LA, so.
Very cool.
I met Will.i.am and Apple in 1993, became really good friends, and we had the same passions and dreams. And luckily, we got Jimmy Iovine from Interscope Records to believe in us.
American Idol.
Yeah, American Idol.
American Idol all the time.
And along the way, we had a couple of kind of like letdowns and records that really didn't sell that much. But luckily, we had a song called "Where's the Love" that came out in 2003. We put Fergie in the group, mm-hmm. and things took off from there. You know, we accomplished a lot of great things because of our tight-knit family and the support that we had within the group.
And what is that like, the creative process when you were writing songs and stuff like that, the Black Eyed Peas? Is it one person has an idea, brings it to somebody else, or is it more of a collaborative thing? Or is it like, you know, Will.i.am comes up with something, then you drop what you want to drop on it, and somebody drops what they want to drop
on it? No, it's a collaborative effort, you know, and it's been like that since we first started. You know, we're all very fortunate to have strong input in what music we put out and the direction of the group, imagery-wise, and just everything that we feel represents the Black Eyed Peas, because what you see on stage is a reflection of who we are off stage as well. We're just crazy and wild and animated type people that just love to have a good time.
And it's not only about the music, because on the radio, on your iPod, it's about the music, but when you put a live show together, you get the latest technology.
Yeah,
you guys spend money, serious cash, to put together this state-of-the-art spectacle.
Well, the thing about it is we're kind of like you, who are visionaries. You're a visionary of what you do and the way that you present, you know, your stage performance and your presence and just everything that goes into the Criss Angel experience. I feel like that's how the Peas are as well, is we really think about the production and the imagery that goes in, the wardrobe, the way that we present and we feed off the crowd, the type of interaction we're going to have with the crowd, the type of, we have so many technical people as far as like the state-of-the-art type of equipment we want to use and the wardrobe, you know, with the lights.
Well,
and
you have
LED.
All the, that's like the newest thing. I see that in Cirque now, the LED lights. Yeah. And they're very problematic. They break down a lot. So you have to have a full-time staff fixing them, right?
Between and they're shows. Always, you know, big up to all the people that were on the end tour because they really put it down for us. We had state-of-the-art, what we did at the halftime show at the Super
Bowl. That was crazy.
Yeah.
I'd love to know what the budget was for that, but you don't have to say that. That must have been just crazy. Yeah, that was just crazy. Just to kind of, I was looking at my Twitter before we had.
Oh yeah,
on.
By the way, you know, follow both of us. If you don't know about Criss Angel, then you've been sleeping under a rock. Follow us on Twitter, TabBEP.
Yep.
TABBEP. We're going to be doing this more often. You're going to see more of us together doing hopefully great things in the future. But please continue to follow TabBEP. What's your Twitter? Nathan Burton, CM. Nathan Burton. Yeah. Don't forget about Big Nate and his shiny shoes. He's the man.
My boy with the kicks.
Yes, sir.
And zippers. Yep.
So how did the name, because people were asking like a stupid question, like how did the name Black Eyed Peas, like I'm sure you had other names you were kicking around, like how did that happen?
Yeah, they were throwing around names.
Like what kind of names?
Like Blue Unit. No, that's whack. Mm-hmm. How about the Ricky Martin crew? Nah, that's horrible.
Nice callback.
How about spaghetti and meatballs? Oh, that's fucking horrible. Can I cuss?
Yeah, sure.
It's okay? All right, shit, fuck.
You can say whatever you want to do. You're Taboo. Black Eyed Peas.
Black Eyed Peas. Oh, wait. Yeah, Black Eyed Peas. What does Black Eyed Peas mean? Oh, well, that's soul food. It's made in the South, right? We feed the soul with our music. Oh, it goes. Boom, pow, pow.
Yeah, and we're going to have a Black Eyed Peas contest later.
Can I tell you something?
I'm not.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hate Black Eyed Peas. I'm sorry to say, I do not like the taste of the Black Eyed Peas. No offense to people that love Black Eyed Peas. Big up. But for me, I just never got into it. I don't like it.
That's like Chris not liking magic. How can you not like the...
Well, if magic was a food, maybe I wouldn't like the taste of it.
Yeah, exactly.
But check it out. We have a question, a video question we're going to go to right now.
Wow, that's big.
Yeah.
It's huge.
Where's the video question? Right here.
Hi, this is Kim from Australia. I have a question for Taboo. I'm a huge Black Eyed Peas fan.
Thank you.
And I need to know what it was like to play at Super Bowl, because it was amazing.
Hey, wait.
Whoa. Happy New Year!
And the Niners win.
Yes. Back to Stu Stone.
Oh, yes.
We're fixing your microphone. Did you hear the question?
No.
What was the question? Did anybody hear the question?
Super Bowl? Yeah, Super Bowl.
Super Bowl. First of all, hello, Ozzy. I love Australia, big day out. We performed there many years ago, and I had a great time there. Super Bowl was amazing, being that I was, as you mentioned, the first Mexican-American, not Ricky Martin, to be Ricky. Able to do that and represent my culture, and also
it's awesome.
To be on that big stage and have my family in the audience. And
how many people were
billions?
Yeah, but how about as far as just
60 billion people watching? Yeah.
But the stadium itself, it was just
electrifying.
How many?
I mean, I know, you know, like on a small scale, you know. When I do some stuff, you know, I get some crowds and stuff like that. But a stadium of that magnitude, it's just at a whole nother level, man. Not many people in their lifetime get to experience anything like that.
I have a dumb question.
How many comp tickets do you get for the Super Bowl when you perform the halftime show? Can you bring 10? Can you bring 5?
It all depends on how many people. We have a big band. You know, not only is it the four P's, but we also have band.
You have like your own skybox with all your.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Yeah. We got a skybox. Skybox, luckily. Yeah.
So what's going on with the Peas right now?
Well, right now we're doing as we did in 2007. We go on a little hiatus after album cycles.
Yeah.
And we focus on individual side projects. Cool. Right now,
I know you're working on some
stuff.
Yes,
I've been working hard, man, and hopefully I could open up for you one day. I know you got a great show popping off, and I want to go check it out.
Best bargain.
I hear a lot of great things about you.
That would be what a bargain ticket that would be to go see Nathan Burton's show.
Nathan Burton.
And no, but before he comes
and opening
out,
up for him,
Taboo from the Black Eyed Peas.
People would be like, "Whoa, Big Nate!" They'd be like, "Best afternoon show ever."
That's good.
How many tickets will you count me for that?
Whatever you want. Whatever you want. That's right.
The house is calm.
God, he's funny.
Oh, he's a very funny
guy.
He's fun.
I thought he was going to be serious.
Yeah, we're going to get serious right now, because what I want to know, people always ask me because I cut my hair.
Yeah.
I had a long hair, like down to my thigh at one time, but your hair was really long as well. I mean, when you first came out, that
girly,
was your look.
Pretty,
do you feel comfortable talking a little
bit
about
that? Yeah, go ahead.
He wants to know what kind of conditioner.
Tell us.
Actually, that's great. You're funny.
Yeah.
You're a funny bitch.
I'm opening up for him.
Wow, now
I'm sorry, Nate.
No, it's okay.
You're sitting right next to me, so it's I have right. to go in on you a little
it's
bit.
It's okay.
Tell us about why you cut your hair. Is it just that you wanted a look to people getting to, you know, characterizing you as...
Well,
you know, the long hair guy in a Black Eyed Peas.
Two reasons. Really two reasons. Not to get like serious,
because
you said I'm funny, and I like that.
You are
I am funny.
You are funny.
I'm a funny person. first of all, the first reason is I cut it for a movie called James E. Boy that will be coming out this year, which I saw yesterday. Amazing movie. I'm proud of it.
Say it again. What's the name of it?
It's called James E. Boy. Okay. Starring James Woods, Spencer, I forgot his last name, sorry, and the woman from Weeds, Marie Parker Lewis? Mary, excuse me. Sorry.
When's it come out?
Comes out, we don't know yet. We don't have a date.
But this year, this year.
But you saw the screening.
Wow. And yeah, what's that like to see a movie you're in?
Is that your first movie?
No, it's my fifth.
Really?
Oh, wow.
God, I'm like snoozing over here.
You're snoozing.
I haven't done one movie yet.
Chris Angel, dude.
Oh, my God. I got to get in the Black Eyed Peas is what I got to do.
No, and then the second reason, Nate, just to get a little serious, I was a drug addict and an alcoholic for many years. And the long hair represented that addiction time. I've been sober for 6 years. Not to get all serious and change the mood.
No, that's you know an inspiration for people that might be watching right now.
Thank you, brother.
God bless you,
and I really owe it to my son who's sitting back there, Josh, and my family.
That's great.
Who if I didn't change, I probably wouldn't be here. And thank God I did for the best. I have three wonderful children, a 19-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 1-year-old, going to be two. Beautiful wife, and I'm living life, man. I'm enjoying
good
it.
Good for you. Man, yes, that's really...
Thank you.
You know, success can be a crazy ride.
Yeah. I actually wrote a book about it, so you could go on Amazon.com and check it out. It's called Falling Up. Pick it up. Yeah. Or you can follow me on Twitter, TabBEP, to find out more information. Plug, plug, plug.
Yeah.
There we go.
Why not?
Or you can follow my man, Nate, on...
Nathan Burton, CM.
There it is.
Now, why'd Criss cut your hair? Why'd you cut your hair?
Because of what I'm going to announce on the 28th.
Oh, see. Yeah. I was trying to get him to tell you, and he'd forget.
Yeah, but I'm announcing on the 28th. You'll know why.
He has a hair salon
But this
opening.
Is not about me.
He has a hair salon opening on the 28th.
Yeah. Wow.
Magic cuts. We're going live.
Tell us a crazy thing, like the craziest thing that ever happened. You know, maybe when you were on stage or doing a tour.
I
like,
broke my tailbone 2006 on stage here in Vegas because I was faded.
Really?
I was drunk off my ass.
And what'd you do, fall off the
stage? I was performing. I was doing the song called Don't Funk With My Heart.
Right.
And you know the monitor?
Well. Mm-hmm.
The monitor has an edge like this.
Yep.
I was standing up on this like...
I understand to be above it.
Yeah, I was above it, fell down and landed on my tailbone. And cracked. My tailbone was gone. I was sitting on a donut for like 6 months. You know what a donut is?
Yeah.
It's horrible. Mm. That's why when the dude was like there, don't ever do that.
When this happened during the show, like, did everybody know
right
away?
It was embarrassing. It was embarrassing because Shannon Elizabeth was sitting in the front row. Brian Austin Green was sitting in the front row. And as soon as I hit the edge of the corner of the monitor, they looked at me and the whole crowd went, and I was like, I'm all right. Walked off limping like, oh shit. You know, and when I got to LA, went to the doctor to the emergency and they said, your coccyx bone is broken. Shattered.
Wow.
Then
you were out of commission.
I was out of commission for about six months.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's just on to brighter things.
Yeah.
I was watching.
I thought that was kind of funny, dude.
No, I don't think that's funny.
You have to make light out of it.
It got all Oprah there for a second.
Yeah. What's interesting is I did hear though on an interview, and I wanted to get this confirmed by you. That at some point when you were on tour, that you made out with Fergie. That she actually is the one who said that.
Like, yes.
Is that true?
You know what happened was, and this is, I guess she said it on Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah.
This is like when we first
shows you what I watch.
Oh, you watch Oprah?
I watch the interview, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Oh. Yeah, so when, in, I believe 2003, we were drinking.
Yeah.
And you know,
playing spin the bottle.
It's just like some, you know, it was harmless, but I guess people made a big deal out of it.
Oh, this was in front of people.
No. I'm just saying, like the people. You know, that. Oh my God.
You
kissed Fergie?
Yeah, no,
oh my God. What about Josh?
It's like,
dude, that's my
yeah.
family.
Yeah.
You know what
no,
I mean?
Josh is great. I did. I actually did an episode of Las Vegas.
Oh, you did?
And Josh
like
was. I loved it. Yeah. Josh was the nicest guy. I was so nervous. You know, about acting and...
You were sick, weren't you? Or was it CSI?
No, that was when I did CSI.
He's a nice guy and he's handsome. He made me nervous, too, when I did Las Vegas. So I was like, dude, I'm not going to look at you because I...
Well, that's how they originally met, when you did Las Vegas.
Yes, and James Caan.
Right? James Caan, right? Wow. He's a very nice guy, too.
Jimmy.
Yeah, very cool. So it was true then?
What?
That happened.
Yeah, it was harmless, dude. Yeah, it wasn't like, here's your kiss. Yeah. Come here, Nate. Yeah. Like one of those types of things. Yeah. This guy.
It wasn't, yeah.
So, what do you, what's Stu?
What, Stu? Yeah, come on, Stu, with your Macho Man Randy Savage.
I was hoping he was going to kiss Nate.
Nah, it's easy, Nate.
We're not like that.
Is there a lot of pressure to come, like, as a solo artist or even with the band? Like, you guys had so much success, you know, just enormous. A global act, each of you a distinct personality that's recognizable in and to yourself. Is it a lot of pressure, like now you're working on music of your own? Do you feel the pressure that you have to outdo or live up to something that people expect, as if, you know, because if you're a new artist, you have no pressure, right? You know, people don't know about you, but now everybody knows about you. It's like when I do a project, people are expecting it to be a certain thing at a certain level. What do you feel?
Well, you know, you always have to maintain the level of integrity and the level of respect for your fan base when you do your side project. And I always think about, you know, does this, whether I'm doing it for the Latino community, because that's...
So you're not going to come out with a jazz album?
I'm not going to come out with a jazzy album. It'll be very reminiscent of the P's, but it'll be more directed to the Latino community because I am Mexican, not Puerto Rican.
Ricky Martin,
yeah. Not Villa Loca, but I'm just saying, like, you know, my thing is to be able to not outdo the P's, because I'll never outdo the P's. I'm not trying to compete with that. My market is different. It's a different lane. I'm not competing with Will.i.am, Fergie, or Apple. Right. We have our synergy as a group, but when you do side projects, you try to always, like I said, keep your integrity, create great music, and my show will always be a banger.
Right.
Well, you know what a banger is?
I think I've had
that
a couple.
It's good.
Oh, I was going to say, I've had a couple of those.
Couple bangers?
I think I've had a couple of those.
You prefer not to talk about him. His fiance is probably watching. Yes.
Oh, right. Congrats.
Thank you very much. Man. Yeah, Chris is engaged, too.
Yeah.
Congratulations,
yes,
brother.
Yes, I am.
Yes, sir.
So
we're live!
Yeah, no, what I was going to say was, this is something you probably don't know, Nathan, seriously.
Okay, I'm serious. Sorry.
I heard a rumor at one point years ago. I'm a big follower of the Black Eyed Peas, I got to tell you.
We're not breaking up.
No, okay, good. That's good. Mm-hmm. We want more music. Mm-hmm. But I heard that
Will.i.am is not Jamaican.
All right, but Apple is Filipino. He's probably the first Filipino to play the Super Bowl as well.
Oh, wow.
Wow,
yes,
Apple,
I
big up.
Yeah, yes, thank you very much. Yes, I bring things to people's attention.
Yes.
The spear forefront there. But what I was gonna say was I heard a rumor that you were gonna write music for David Copperfield's show many years ago, but
what?
That never happened. Tell us about that.
You know what?
I didn't know
David
this.
Copperfield's a good friend of mine, you know, and I'm just a fan of magic.
Right.
I'm a fan of performance and art.
Sure.
And when I see somebody that is definitely doing something to advance the art form, I always give credit to that and respect. And when I first met David Copperfield, you know, he was at the top of his game, as he always is, you know. Never take any credit away from anybody. I just enjoyed the opportunity to meet him. And we talked about it, but nothing ever happened. Yeah.
Did he have like an illusion in mind, like for the piece of music? Or was it
no,
very
it was just
like
very, you know, it's hip hop talk, B. Hip hop talk. You understand what that is? Hip hop talk is yo, we're gonna hook up. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Let me get your number. Yeah, okay. We're gonna do this, we're gonna do that, and it never happens.
Yeah.
That's hip hop talk.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, so it's always with a this and a hug.
Yeah, because I was wondering, because he actually told me about that.
Really?
Back in 2005, or probably was, or 6. Mm-hmm. And he said, yeah, they're doing my whole soundtrack, and it's going to be an album. And,
wow.
And
that would have been big, but it never happened,
yeah.
So, you know.
So is this the same thing that we're talking about doing, and it's just
it's not, it can be hip-hop talk, because
What are we talking here? Tell me.
I think the relationship that we're building as friends and as people who appreciate and respect our art forms is a little bit more personal.
Yeah.
And, you know, I love the people that you're around. T is a really good dude, you know, just by meeting him the first time and then today.
Who's T?
T.
Who's T?
T.
Tommy?
Tommy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry. I call him T.
I'm sorry.
We're like that, right, T?
I'm pretty white. I didn't know who T was. I was like, who's T?
T.
Like
you know, Tommy's Mexican. Like, you didn't know that?
I didn't know Tommy's Mexican.
He's part of my barrio.
I didn't know Tommy was Mexican.
But
he's a Raiders fan. Come on, dude.
There you go.
Well, it was
how
great.
Mexican do you? You can't get
now,
more
you
Mexican.
Know,
than
have you
that.
Ever heard of one of Chris's songs?
He's been to the show.
Yes.
No. I mean,
you saw Believe recently.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, he brought his posse.
What?
Yeah.
posse.
Get, it's and very, they're all
this
white.
Show's very urban today.
Yeah.
Posse, yeah, G-Money.
You know, when run Rome, when you're in Rome, you're Rome, you know? But no, you came to the show. You saw what, about a month ago?
A month ago, yeah.
What was your favorite illusion in his show?
I would have to say the, I really liked when you were twisting up. That was the Houdini thing.
Right, I like that
because...
Over your head.
Over the head. Yeah. I like to go into the audience too. Yeah. That's like my thing, is connecting with the audience and taking my performance from the stage into the audience.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, you break that wall.
Break the wall and not be afraid to make them part of your show.
Yeah, or, I think that's important. You have to make people feel like they're in the experience and not watching the experience. Yeah.
And that's what it is. It's the Criss Angel experience. I know it's believed, but I felt like I was part of that. You know,
cool.
Even though I wasn't on stage, like that kid that you brought on stage.
Yeah.
That was fresh. I like that too.
Well, thank you so much. What questions do you want to know?
Have you ever broken your tailbone on stage?
Never broke. I got a hernia, but I performed.
You got a hernia?
I had a hernia and I performed. I had 5 days to get it fixed, and then I performed with that and a deviated septum at the same time. They had to wrap me up.
Oh, yeah.
I have ligaments torn right now, but I still do the show.
Yeah.
I'm looking at my questions up there. Talk about Falling Up. What's that about?
Falling Up is the book that I wrote.
Where can people get it?
Amazon.
Okay.
It's the first autobiography out of the book.
It's inspirational, motivational. That's great.
Of a kid having dreams to become a successful artist, but getting caught up in the addictions of alcoholism and drug abuse, and overcoming that.
Right.
And you know, it's done wonders for me because it's more of a motivational piece, more than, hey, buy my book. I want to sell books.
Yeah, yeah.
It's more if you pick it up. Yeah, if you pick it up and you're inspired by it, then that's what I want to get across.
Was there a moment when you were like, you've made it? You were like, this is what being a star is. What was that?
Sitting next to you, dude.
Okay.
No, I'm seriously. No. I gotta tell you because.
Okay. All right. No, but seriously, in your
I'm
career.
I'm fucking with you.
I know. But
come on.
It would have been cool if that was true.
What do you think to Nate's question? What was that moment where you said? Because in the beginning, for me, it was like people would come up to me, can I get an autograph? I was like, this is going to go, I'm going to wake up tomorrow and it's going to be gone.
Yeah.
You know, what was the moment where you realized, from a financial point of view and from fame point of view, like, I think I've made it?
I would have to say probably the first time I bought a home, my first house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I was sleeping on my mom's couch, kid. And it was like, I was on the radio. We had a song called Joints and Jams, and I would come home and watch my video on TV and be on my mom's couch. Like, good night, Mom. You know, and it was like, wow, I'm still sleeping on my mom's couch. And not until 2003 did the monetary success come to fruition.
And it's not an easy thing to have, right?
Is that the right word, Deja? All right, I just learned that word the other day. I'm trying to change my vocabulary. Like if somebody says, how are you doing? Hey, I'm good. No, I'm doing very well.
So buying a house for your mom?
Buying a house for my mom.
Yeah, that's cool. That's huge. But I'm sure you had, like you were saying before, because...
No, wait. I didn't get there. I bought a house for myself.
He lived with his mom.
Yeah, I lived with my mom. You got
Nathan,
the stories confused.
You got to follow.
You're like bored right now, dude.
No. I'm listening. I wanted to hear. I thought...
No, but did you get like a ton? Did you guys get like a ton of rejection letters and stuff like that? Like I saved my rejection letters. Like I would come. I came to Las Vegas in the '90s, and I went to like a C-level manager to try to help me, perpetuate my
career.
What
does that mean? C-level.
Like not like the big manager or like even a medium size. It was like a small little, and the manager didn't even reject me in a letter. His assistant rejected me in a letter. And you know, you get all, I have books of rejection letters, but it took me 18 years. You didn't have that experience of like a lot of years of like just, no, we don't get it, this is not happening right now. Because you guys, you know, from a music point of view, you broke a lot of rules and really created a genre and a sound, you know, by incorporating lots of different styles of music. Wasn't it hard to get that?
It was hard because you gotta understand when the first type of group that had the diversity makeup of a Filipino Mexican dude and a black dude from East LA, and then you have Ferg who's everything. She's not just white; she's Irish and
Great
Scottish
boy.
And Native American. She's everything, you know. And people were like, we don't know what to do with this. We had a live band, you know, it was a hip hop group with the live band. They're like, well, we really don't know what to do with this. We don't know how to market this. Mm-hmm. And luckily, Jimmy Iovine from Interscope believed in us, And our song Where's the Love took off, and it just changed the whole game.
Are you still with Interscope?
Yeah, we're still with Interscope. Wow. Yeah, yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, I got a question.
Yeah.
Why do they call you Moo Moo?
It's a long story. Yeah, I know.
Can you do a short version of it?
Technically, it's not my name. We got in this thing where Criss and I were talking about what girl calls Criss, his fiance calls him, mm-hmm. and that's his nickname, and I got stuck with it. I don't know.
Full of shit.
No, it's true.
It's not true whatsoever.
People send me cartons of milk, and I'm like, why am I getting milk?
Yes, that is not true.
When they
was called Moo Moo because he was trying to nurse animal were you trying to get milk from?
Wow.
I don't remember what animal.
You don't remember that?
I was probably drinking. I was probably faded.
Faded.
Okay.
Faded.
I probably broke my tailbone. Call back!
Yeah, that was good. That was really good.
You don't remember that?
No. Well, okay. What are we talking about?
It doesn't matter. Anyway, the little teat.
Oh, the little teat. I'll tell you, Criss is a big fan of American Idol, mm-hmm. and he gets those packages they put together. He gets very into it, and sometimes he'll have a little tear, and his fiance will be like, oh, baby Moo Moo.
Is that true?
That's true.
Is that true?
No, it's not true.
No,
he's absolutely insane.
The packages are very well done. And the kid is homeless, and Criss is just like, he'll be tearing, and she'll stroke and rub his feet while they watch American Idol. That's a little inside.
Let's get on to a real question. What kind of musical influences did you have and still have? What do you like that's out there?
I would have to say it started with, of course, hip-hop music.
Right.
Tribe Called Quest, De La Soul. Mm-hmm. KRS-One, mm-hmm. to Farside in L.A., to N.W.A., which is really weird because
it's a little extreme.
Mm-hmm. Public Enemy, mm-hmm. love Flavor Flav, big up to Flavor Flav, living in Vegas now, to Bob Marley, Prince, Stevie Wonder, a lot of Motown.
Did you ever meet
music.
Prince?
Yeah, I got a funny story
I
about
loved,
Prince.
I never met the guy.
I got a I've funny drunk I, story Sheila about
came,
Prince.
Sheila E. was at my New Year's Eve party, not this one, I think the last year, Sweetheart. And she obviously works with Prince, but Flav did a little thing with him just recently. But tell me a story. I think we...
It's a long version. I mean, it's too long to...
Can you make it like
make it short?
Can you make like a short one?
Well, it's in my book. You could get on Amazon.com.
Pick up more stories.
It's on Amazon.com. It's called
Really
Falling Up. Yeah. It's in
Falling
my book.
Up.
A lot of crazy, interesting stories.
Just give us one little thing that would happen with Prince.
Well,
no one's watching this, trust me.
Well, we had a jam session at Prince's house in 2007 for after the
Indianapolis?
Grammys. No, it was here in LA.
Oh, okay.
And it was a jam session, and my partner Apple was rapping, and then I grabbed the mic, and I was like, say rock that shit, as hip hop artists do, and the crowd said rock that shit.
I said
that funky
show,
shit.
I said that
I didn't know you were a hip hop artist.
The kids love it. They
like,
the
kids are like, rock that shit, Nathan.
And the mom's like,
oh,
yes.
You have little kids?
Oh yeah, they're like, rock that shit.
The kids?
No.
What's your fan base?
Kids. No, I get families.
You get families? Okay, cool. That's
magic.
Cool. Yeah, that's
magic.
Fine.
Magic
that's
for
cool,
everyone.
Dude.
I'm gonna rock the shit today in the show. My show today.
Are you?
Maybe. If you come, I'll say rock that shit, and I'll get in trouble, but I will.
So anyways, make a long story short, I was cussing, and Prince's assistant said, please get off the microphone. I said, why? The crowd is feeling it. There's no kids in the audience. It's all
adults.
Don't tell
me it's like a church or something.
Yeah, it was.
What's
it?
Whoa!
It wasn't a church, but he made his house the God of Jehovah. I mean, the house of Jehovah. So no disrespect to any religious people out there, but I was... not knowing that I walked into something that
you
was a little sacred, and I felt bad. I felt like, wow, I just...
He didn't say it, though.
He came to me after, and when everybody left, and pulled me into a room and kind of like gave me a lecture about not cussing in his house, about Jehovah.
Yeah, but he he's...
Know.
Yeah, and I started thinking like...
But hold on a second,
Nicky,
I saw him on MTV Music Awards with his pants with...
I remember that. And that's
see through.
Prince is telling me not to cuss
cream,
in his house.
Yeah. And,
I felt weird. I was like, wow, you used to make a lot of sexual songs, and now you're telling me not to cuss.
He sounded like he had an orgasm in a couple of them.
So that's
is it not true, you know?
Like, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so I felt like that was.
You know, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy. And the Purple Rain, obviously. Anything else with any other celebrity? Anything crazy? Any dirt about the
band?
Oh,
yeah, yeah. When I was smoking weed, I smoked weed with Rick James.
Rick James, God rest his soul, he's no longer
God rest
us.
His soul. Smoke Weed with Rick James. I know this is whack because I'm like sober now, but yeah. it was a weird moment because he had never smoked out of a blunt, which is weird. And I'm sorry to be talking about this, but I mean, you know, it's people want to know the real.
Rick James.
So Rick James, bitch. Yeah. Remember that from Dave Chappelle?
Chappelle.
Yeah.
Sorry, we don't cuss in Chris's house.
Yeah.
Sorry, sir. But I could cuss at your show, huh?
Oh yeah.
In front of the families.
Yeah.
So you guys gonna be hooking up in the near future to work on new material, you think?
Or you know what?
Do you have like a plan cycle that you take a break and it's like, okay, on the 31st,
January,
it just happens.
It just happens.
Who usually reaches out first?
It varies.
Whoever spent the money the most.
It varies.
How does it work? Someone sends you an email, like show up and we start?
No, we just keep in touch with each other and you know, when it happens, it happens. Right now I'm focused on my solo career. Created this great album that I know will be coming out this year. Follow me on Twitter to find out more information about that. Taboo EP, my book, Falling Up, which is at Amazon.com. And a lot of great things happening this year. Touring, I'll be touring February 11th in Europe. I'm doing my first tour this year in Europe.
Are you going to be in Vegas touring?
I'm in Vegas, Club Moon, residency.
That's tonight.
Yeah. You're in Vegas, you can come tonight.
Come tonight.
And there's a good chance you might even see us there.
Yes, please, come. And he's bringing all the families
tonight.
Maybe
we'll bring Flavor Flav there too.
Flavor Flav. Yeah,
so we'll come tonight and then you get free tickets to go to his show.
Yes.
Tell him where you're at.
Planet Hollywood.
Planet Hollywood, you can check out all the great moms and the MILFs and the grandmas.
I get a lot of hot moms.
You can check out all the great hot moms that come out and support my man, Nate.
Needs his own show.
He should have it. You want your own show, you can have your own show.
Thank you, brother.
I think we're going to do a little, just one other thing. Any dirt that you can tell us about the Black Eyed Peas? Anything that we don't know that you can make like breaking news right here on our little webcast?
Tell us a story that's never been told.
Like just something like, do you guys fight a lot or do you get along like family or something, you know, like you get along great?
Yeah, it's not really, like I don't really remember any altercations or fighting amongst, you know, me, Will, or App, or Fergus.
Do you guys split all the writing credit and publishing and all that stuff?
Is
that
it's pretty much four ways? It's pretty equal.
So you've made a lot of money, my guys.
I got a feeling tonight's gonna be
Do you know? Do you know that I was on Oprah when you did that song in Chicago? Do you know that I was on the
show? Fresh kid.
Do you remember that?
That was nice.
You don't remember.
He was faded.
Will I Am walked off the stage and he's like, "Yo, what's up, Chris? Fergie." You were there too. But we didn't know each other at the time. But that's Oprah's favorite moment.
That was amazing. We shut
down.
That
flash dance was crazy. It was like, how many, 10,000 people?
20,000.
20,000 people. Mm-hmm. That was amazing.
Yeah.
That was amazing. That song's amazing. Tommy, that's Tommy's, one of Tommy's favorite songs. Where are you, Tommy?
You mean
Right, Tommy? Oh, he just left. That's one of his favorite. But you make bank, man.
You make like Criss Angel money.
I'm not on some Criss Angel money.
Criss Angel money right there.
Do the math. 55 million albums, right?
Times
about $1.50.
$1.50?
$1.50, $2 an album. Well, it depends. So downloads, now it's about $1. Anyway, you do the math, plus all the live shows. Oof. I bet you they did the deal with Interscope a long time ago, so it's not like a deal that they participate in everything. And the merchandising.
So when you go to the ATM,
crazy.
And you get like $200 out.
He doesn't get $200.
No, but I'm saying, he
owns an ATM.
It says like balance. Does it even fit on the little ATM? Is it just like 1000 balance? Because when I go, it's like $400.
And then you over.
Yeah, then you overdraft. Yeah. So you never overdraft. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
You know, we've been blessed.
Yeah, I've been blessed.
Take the high road.
Your health, honestly, we joke around about money. If you have your health, you are blessed. You have everything.
And honestly, I'm blessed to have my family, which is the rock and the thing that keeps
you grounded.
Family's most important.
Yeah, you know, and without them, you wouldn't go, I feel like I owe everything to them.
And now you have Moomoo to keep you grounded.
And also,
I want to
you know, I'm going to take my family to go see your show. It's a family show, I'll bring my kids, my wife, and my mom.
Yeah, you can definitely
Chris
do that.
Chris has seen the show like 10 times.
We're going to be doing an actual breakdance competition.
Are you going to dance?
I'm not dancing.
He
dances really good. So Moomoo's going to do a little breakdancing. We got Taboo. They're going to compete. Oh! Oh, none. Really? You, he's calling you out right over there.
Mateo.
Stu, please take it over.
Yes, we have, you know, Taboo, legendary. A lot of people know that he's a great rapper, a member of the Black Eyed Peas, but a lot of people might not realize that Taboo is actually a world-class, world-renowned breakdancer extraordinaire.
Come on, let me see the whole style.
And here in Stu's corner, we have our very own breakdancer extraordinaire, Mateo, the maestro. Is actually
all right. Relax. Don't get into it yet. I'm gonna just sit back.
Now, what
here.
We have done is we have set
can
up.
Can I interrupt you for
please,
a second?
Yes.
We couldn't afford anything else. I'm
no,
sorry.
No,
we don't have your.
No.
We don't have your bank.
Can I?
No,
it's not. It's not the cardboard. It's the fashion. Can we get a shot of the fashion here, please? Ladies and gentlemen, if you please look at the orange hat tilted to the side, right? And
maestro,
mas chingón. Right? and then he has the orange, I don't even know, where is this from, Spain? Barcelona?
That's U-Haul.
Okay. And then we got the funky boots and the crazy, I don't even know what you call that. That's like
the Jack Sparrow pants.
The Jack Sparrow pants. I don't think that's an outfit that you would be rocking or b-boying in, just to be honest with you. So I'm going to have to keep you upstairs, which means that you're only going to pop. Okay?
Wait, he's calling you out. Do you have any words?
You're only going
to. I'm doing your job. Do you have any words to fight back with?
Words?
Words.
My word is here. Show me your fucking dance.
Whoa!
Wait, ladies, not in my house. Not in my house.
Ladies and gentlemen, he may speak with an accent, but he doesn't think with an accent. The man is very talented. Although he has the wackest fucking outfit on the planet, he is ready for war and ready for battle in Santa Monica. He is definitely ready to party with the belly. The belly, check out the belly. The belly is really sticking out.
He'll show
out,
you
right?
His belly if you want to see his belly.
So he's going to do some belly waves today. That's what he's going to, the belly rolls, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's start with that first. Okay, here we go. Do we have any music?
We have music. Yes. Okay. Let's
it's
roll
generic
our
license-free music.
We can't even. Use
thank you, Heat.
let's run the breakdancing music.
You're warming up, right?
Yeah.
Watch you don't fall. The
yeah,
cardboard.
Like,
though.
I feel like I'm watching Electric Boogaloo too. Oh!
Whoa!
Ladies and gentlemen,
Turbo.
Ladies and gentlemen, why do they always make the Latinos act like fucking fools?
No, we don't make them. This is what he does naturally.
Ay, cabrón, te chingaste. Let's see. Ladies and gentlemen, we have. Ladies and gentlemen, what we're saying right now is we are enjoying every moment of this show. I think he basically just wrecked it. He wrecked shop, as we say in hip hop terminology. He put it down.
Wrecked shop, Stu.
He wrecked shop.
Wait, Stu, Macho Man, what do you have to say about
that? I would love to see. I mean, there's obviously room for improvement here. Maybe you could teach him.
Do we want to get rid of this out of
here? Yeah, we can get rid of this.
Yeah, let's get rid of this. I'm sorry. I know it's a small one because you're a little smaller than everybody else, but.
Okay, that outfit is horrible.
Just try to see past the outfit.
Right.
Okay.
Do you want some music? Do you want some music?
I'm going to give, just a little bit not so.
I don't think we can afford anything else outside of
that.
Do
we have something a little
slower? Do we have anything else, or is that the best
we can
do
right now?
We can't play the Black Eyed Peas.
Can we play the Black Eyed Peas? No, because the publishing, Jimmy will.
We'll have to pay him?
All right, yeah,
so,
we'll have to pay
check
him.
So check this out. Let's learn one of the most standard moves, which is called up rocking.
How's that?
Up rocking. We're gonna learn some up rocking.
So I'm gonna do it.
Don't get your pants dirty. Those are expensive.
No. I'm gonna do it very slow, so you get the
perfect. Okay. So first, back, boom, 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 boom. Right.
Oh.
Good.
So then, when it's spread up, it looks like this. Boom. Can you turn off the music? This is kind of throwing me off. Yeah. Your own beat. Here we go. Right?
Good. Get human beatbox. Go ahead. No, Stu will give you a little beatbox. Go ahead.
Right?
Come on.
Here we go.
Wrap it up.
One, two, here. So you gotta move from side to side. Here. Like this.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Come on.
You like this. Boom. Boom. Boom.
This is like when you call somebody out breakdancing.
There you go.
And then, that's pretty good.
Put your hand on your head. Put your hand on your head. Stop.
Yeah, yeah, worm. Go the worm. Do the dolphin. Do the dolphin.
Then he messes himself up. Look, this is... You gotta look cool, man. You gotta represent us.
You can do the slow motion. Don't you do the slow motion?
Do the tick.
Boom. Boom. Right? Make it look cooler.
Come on.
I'm a cool guy. Double. Chaparrito, chingon. Wait, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, Nathan.
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 Let's go, Nathan.
There you go.
Go, white boy. Go, white boy.
I feel like New Year's Eve. I feel like Stu Stone.
He might be hopeless.
I feel like a Carl's Jr. Commercial right there.
Stu, I think you should participate. You're not really talking very much. He actually does.
Go, Stu.
It's your birthday.
Go, Stu.
He's a Jew.
Go. He's a Jew. Little Jew.
Half
He's
price. A Jew. Chris can break
dance. I think it's important, Taboo. The pants a little bit down, no?
Oh, no! Mateo! No!
Nalgon!
No!
Wow, is this live?
Yeah, this is live.
You had the gall to talk to me about my show earlier. Yeah, I didn't have that.
Yo, this guy's got balls.
He's got one ball. He's got one ball.
He's like Lance.
He's got one ball.
The picture with the dog on Twitter.
Yeah. Can you give him a grade on his dancing?
You know what? I would have to say it's a C.
A C.
It's a C.
Yeah.
For caliente, cabrón.
For culo.
I would say more practice. Okay. A little bit slower, not so goofy. Okay. And then you'll be fresh, kid. Perfect. Remember the terminology, fresh kid.
Yes. Fresh kid.
Yeah.
Kid fresh.
Yeah.
Anything you want to ask the master?
No, master.
Well, no, actually, there is something else that Mateo's going to do.
Yeah. Well, I was just going to bring it up because you're going to challenge him.
I thought it was going to be...
No, it's you. I have a show.
Yeah, he has a white shirt
it's
on.
Definitely
it's
definitely not me.
Black eyed peas.
Yes, it's you.
Contest. It's you. Wow. Who can eat more black-eyed peas in how long of a period of time?
How long?
It was supposed to be him, and it was supposed to be a minute and a half.
No, it's Stu now. Minute and a half. Because you ate it on New Year's Eve, you get to do it.
Yes. Okay, here we go. Bring out Stu Stone, ladies and gentlemen. Cool, you're going to want to watch it. Skip back here with me, Taboo. You're going to enjoy this. Just don't make a big mess.
Can I give it play-by-play?
Yeah, also in Chicklet.
He's
going to
do
commentary.
He's going to do color commentary.
Now, what are we doing? What's the exact...
Whoever eats the most in a minute and a half.
Do we have a stopwatch?
Let me
show you the goodness right over here, as Luke Dancy would say.
We have a stopwatch.
This is going to be eaten. No hands can be used.
No hands.
No hands can be used.
Put your hands behind your back.
This has to be done strictly...
No, they don't need a mic.
Can I give you this, Jesse?
Feel good?
Si, feel good.
Tell people what you're feeling right now.
I feel very chingon. Very chingon.
Oh, thank you. Okay.
We got.
There it is.
Okay, let's get a nice shot. Can we get a nice tight shot? Just one second here. Let's just get the. This.
And also food.
This will.
Stu, are you ready?
Will be very interesting, and it will.
He's not feeling this. Ladies and gentlemen, the black eyed peas do not look that enticing.
I am personally going to give, I can't afford Taboo's type of money, but I'm personally giving $100.
$100.
$100. And free drinks for the night for the winner of this.
Yes, nice.
And I don't care if you drink one drink or you drink 100 drinks, I got you covered. Okay?
And Vegas.
Kick your brains out. If
Vegas.
That's what you
wait. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry to interrupt, Chris.
Yes.
I will give another $100 if Nate joins the party.
$100
right here for Nate to get involved.
No, I'm good. I got a show. These are the two.
Nate.
Look at that.
Nate, there you go. Nate, where's my $100, Tommy? Can I
have
my wallet?
Nate.
Come on. Stu's in. I got a white shirt.
Could we get you a black shirt? We can get you a little small.
I got a show. I can't eat all that stuff.
Okay.
No. Yeah, I'll be puke.
All right. We'll go with Stu. And you can take your $100 back.
Stu already ate it on New Year's Eve. I have to work and
reputation. And this is what we're going to do. So. It's going to be 1.5 minutes, 90 seconds. I just screwed up the clock.
Here you go, sir.
We have a backup one.
You have one? Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, thank you very much.
$100. All you
can
drink.
This is my $100 right there.
And a DVD copy of Stu Stone's New Year's Eve show.
Oh,
yes. And here we go. Are you ready, Stu?
Yeah, hands on the table.
You can't use your hands. You can't use your hands.
No, you can't.
And don't make a mess, because I don't.
Hands behind your back. You know.
Nate, you got him.
I got him. Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Not like this.
Watch out, Chicklet. It could get ugly over here, and you'll start eating everything. Ready?
Pretend like it's a lady.
Ready?
I'm going to hype you up, kid.
Set. Go.
Go, Stu. Come on. Do it for Randy Macho Man Savage. Come on. Do it for Hulk Hogan. Come on. Do it for Ricky the Dragon Steeple. WWF.
Oh, it's hot.
Vince McMahon. Let's go.
Eat it.
You're a thrill. Real G. You can eat it all. Come on. Eat it all. Get it all. Don't get it in there. He's going to throw up.
Come on.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's coming out of his nose. It's coming out of his ear.
Black eyed peas.
He's got it all in his face. Go deep.
He's all in that.
He's getting it.
Fergie, stop it. It's not Fergie. Come on.
Take it all like a hooker down Sunset. Go. Take it. All up in your mouth. It's $100. You're getting a lot of great stuff with $100. Come on, Stu.
All you can drink tonight. All you can drink.
You're halfway there. 45 seconds left.
Free drink tickets. Come on, bro.
Come on.
Get in there.
Stu, eat that. Come on, eat it.
You can puke it out later.
Wow. Yeah,
go,
eat it.
Come on.
Come on, give it.
It is a real $100 bill, ladies and gentlemen.
This is tax free.
This is real.
We're gonna go ahead.
Come on, viral video. Think of it, Stu. Bigger than New Year's Eve. Come on.
Stu, come on, Stu.
You can stop right now. It'll be bigger than New Year's Eve.
Stu,
it's on the jacket.
Oh, man. Come on. We got, it's 5 seconds, 4 seconds, 3 seconds,
and
done.
Stu.
Hold on. We have to, he pushed to the side a little bit. I think we have to go by.
Okay.
No, I think we have to weigh it.
We have to weigh it. Was it equal weights, Tommy, when it came in?
Good job, Stu. It's horrible.
Two cans.
Oh, you know who won this?
Stu.
You just... We'll talk about it.
Okay.
No, not you. Know you don't touch it. Go ahead. You just touch. You're not a judge. Okay. Now, ladies, we're gonna have to confer. Let's go over here. Let's
call on.
Just stay there.
Stay there. Who? Yeah. Mateo. Yeah. I think so.
All right. I'll let Taboo announce the official winner of $100.
All you can drink tonight.
That is equivalent to, what is that, 10,000 pennies.
Yeah, and it's also equivalent to free tickets at my show tonight at Club Moon.
Yeah, this is going to be fantastic. If you're watching this right now and you're in Vegas or in Arizona, you can, or California, get in the car, drive to Moon, that is over at the Palm.
Yes, come down.
And hang, I'll be there too. Nathan will be there.
Come on, Nate.
All right, but the winner, let's have $100.
All you can drink.
All you can drink.
One free download of the Black Eyed Peas song.
Yes, sir.
On iTunes.
Free tickets to the family gathering at
Nathan Burton Show.
Nate Burt.
Nathan Burton.
Nate Burt.
G Money. Mm-hmm. And the winner
is Fresh
Kid, Break My Tailbone.
Yes,
and the winner is Don't Cuss.
Rub your belly.
And the winner is, ladies and gentlemen.
Rub your pouch.
My pouch?
Your pouch.
Is that my wallet?
It's your pouch.
Is that my pouch?
It's a very hairy pouch. Go ahead.
The winner is.
Good.
I'm doing American Idol, when you cry when you watch it.
I'm trying.
I gotta go commercial. And we're back on a break. And we're back. And the winner. Stu Stone.
Stu.
Stu. Stu. Stu. Stu. Stu.
Yes. Get your phone out of here before it gets ugly. Get your phone.
Whose phone is this?
Hey, thanks so much for watching. Thanks to our amazing guest, Taboo, from Black Eyed Peas. Thanks, Black Eyed Peas, for great music. Thank you, Maestro, for being such a good sport. Stu Stone for always
winning.
And Nathan Burton, the best bargain show, and honestly, the best afternoon show in Vegas.
Nate.
And would compete with
G-Money.
Some evening shows and probably kick their ass, a lot of them.
I'm faded right now.
And he's got the great white shirt on.
Yes.
That's right.
I also want to say, coming up, we have next, and we're going to have a very special guest, a really talented musician. He is The Heat. He'll be there along with Luke Dancy.
Heat, big up to him.
Yep. And Jesse's going to be doing some magic, so don't move. We have a lot more right here, Loyal Saturday. God bless you all. Live your dreams.
Stay locked.
Bang a gong.
Good job, man.
ham.